over at Desplaines and Kinsey at the Jewel-Osco for Fill a Bag, Fill a Bus. It's going to be a great day. The need is great, right?
The need is great. 812,000 neighbors rely on the food depository every year. So an event like Fill a Bag, Fill a Bus is fantastic. Come on out, everybody.
It's so simple. We're going to be here until about noon today. We're going to be Skates, you look like you need a bag to help out with. There you go. Skates for the Chicago Wolves helping out. He's going to be helping out. And Mary Frances, it really is that simple. It's filling a bag, filling a bus, and it's really a great partnership.
Oh, it absolutely is. You know what? Every year, Jewel-Osco donates millions through the Fresh Rescue Program to the Greater Chicago Food Depository. So this is just one more avenue, and we're so thankful to our customers and, of course, our vendors who make all of this possible.
Why does Jewel-Osco decide to partner with us on this every single time we do this?
Well, we're active in the community. We have them. We know how important this is. We know how important Greater Chicago Food Depository is, and so do our customers. And that's why we're so pleased, and we love doing this every time we get a chance.
I like any campaign that the name of it is exactly what you're supposed to do, because Mary Frances, it really is that easy. You see our folks here out of the Kinsey and Desplaines location now, or we're going to be at Roosevelt and Canal a little bit later on today. You get that bag, you fill it, you get it on the bus.
Exactly. It's that simple. When they walk in, we'll see a bunch of volunteers in the Greater Chicago Food Depository, and whatever we need, whatever they need, will be listed on there. They can fill up the bag and put it in here.
I'm excited. We've recruited Alicia here to be on TV, too. She's our driver from the Chicago Trolley and Double Decker coming. How are you doing this morning, Alicia?
I'm doing quite well. Thank you.
You're excited to be a part of this this morning?
I am very excited to be here this morning. Yeah, yes, I am.
Now that you got your coffee.
That's right.
Here we go. And really, Amy Squires, we've got to ask. We were talking about the need a little earlier. I hope we could expand just a little bit. For every donation, every meal that comes to you guys, how many people does that help?
So for every dollar that's brought in, it provides three meals. So this is a great event. People fill this bag up. We get it out to our neighbors. We're really excited to be here.
And we can't go without mentioning Rick O'Dell for Meet TVFM. Rick, how you doing this morning?
Real good. It's great to be able to do this event with you when it's not 10 degrees out.
Yes, we do it in the winter, and it is often very cold. A nice summer day here for us today.
Beautiful.
Beautiful. We'll love it. And we're going to be here all morning long again. Helping me tell the weather will be Skates here from the Chicago Wolves, one of our great partners for Fill a Bag, Fill a Bus. All right, so Skates, it's going to be a warmer day today. So what do you do for a warmer day? The sun is out of the sky. Things are open. Are you putting on sunscreen? Yeah, a little sunscreen. That's important on a sunny day. Maybe you're going to go for a jog. You're going to take a nice run along the lakefront. Right, right, right. Things are going to, ooh, maybe a little hula dancing as well. Oh, well, so you're doing really good. That's a nice, sounds like a nice, fun day. Sounds like a perfect day for it as well. Gorgeous sunrise over Chicago today. Amy Squires, I think a lot of people think, oh, the holidays, that's when people need food the most. It's a year-round thing, and especially here in the summer, it's definitely a need for in Chicago.
Yeah, it's a year-round issue, but definitely in the summer, you know, kids usually get some breakfast and lunch at school during the day, and when they're not in school, they don't get that breakfast and lunch. So a program like this, Fill a Bag, Fill a Bus, is instrumental in getting that food to those kids this summer.
And we're having fun because Tony here, you're a customer, you walked in and you made a big donation for us here today. Why?
Well, I think it's the right thing to do. And once in my life, I was once homeless, and I know how it feels to go without food. And I think Chicago Food Depository and Jewel doing a wonderful job. So I think it's the best thing to do is to give right back. It's the Christian way to do it.
Tony, I didn't know that you had experienced homelessness yourself. Yes, if you could just chat about, I mean, obviously that must be something really rough to go through, and it must just feel nice to be able to know that you're going to be able to help people that are going through that same scenario.
Yes, sir, it is. And I lost my job. I had a good job. I was able to take care of my family, and I lost my job. And the funny thing about this is that my wife also worked for Jewel.
Oh, wow.
And it's a very sad story because five children, my wife and I, and my wife supported us. And I couldn't find a job 5 years.
Wow.
It was hard. And Jewel employed my wife. And like I say, it's,
wow.
I don't want to get all into it.
But Tony, no, I mean, that's,
it's,
I mean,
the right thing to do.
And I think that just goes to underscore the situation. I think a lot of us have in mind what homelessness looks like. It takes on many different forms, and there's so many people that need help. Tony, thank you so much for your donation. And Phil, that must be a story that brings a lot of joy to you as well, just knowing that we're able to give back in many ways.
Yep. Tony is one of our regular shoppers, and also we've been doing this last 2 years. We've been participating with the Chicago Food Depository, and we're a proud sponsor to help out the needy families in Chicago.
Here we go. You're going to carry. Well, they've already filled the bag. You're going to fill the bus. Really quickly, why is it important for me, TVFM, to take part in this?
Good morning, John, first of all. And I come dressed to work, so put me to work. I'll be happy to carry as many bags as we need to this morning. We've counted on MeTVFM listeners before. They've come through really big for us in Fill a Bag, Fill a Bus. We're asking them to do the same again today till noon here at the Kinsey and Desplaines Jewel-Osco location. Then later on today, a donation of a canned good, cans, fruits, peanut butter, and or a cash donation at the website, WCIU.com.
And then at 1 o'clock, we're moving to the South Loop. We're going to be at Roosevelt and Canal till 5 o'clock, 1 to 5. Amy Squires, why is that so important that everyone donate today if they can?
812,000 of your neighbors rely on the Greater Chicago Food Depository every year. So this is such an amazing experience for us. Summer is especially important. Kids who don't get breakfast and lunch, they won't get a breakfast and lunch because they're not in school. So we need to fill that bug, fill that bus, and get the food.
Just fill everything. Fill the bag, fill the bus. Just make sure you're helping out. Yeah. And Mark, why is that so important to you guys here at Jewel-Osco?
Well, Jewel-Osco, we are local. We continue to have plenty of opportunities with our customers to be able to help them donate. They use us as a vehicle to be able to do that. We are local. We are the community. It's really important for us to be able to help those in need, and I believe our customers share that same passion.
Well, you mentioned that it's about community here at Jewel-Osco, but while you're here, people are already thinking about how they're going to feed their families in the evening, how they're going to do that, and it just makes sense that your customers are like-minded as well, that they want to help others out.
Absolutely. Come out and help support this great cause.
Phil, you having fun here this morning so far?
Oh, yeah. We've already had a lot of customers come through, and it's very exciting. Good to see. It's a great cause.
You must get to know the customers that come in every day or once a week, and it must give you joy to see them being willing to give back too.
Absolutely. Everybody is just very happy to participate, see a lot of our regulars, out there, and it's great for the community.
Now, right. Skates from the Chicago Wolves has been hanging. Skates, you've been hanging out? Wake up, Skates. Oh, he's got the, oh, there we go, Skates, there we go. He's awake now. All right, so you just took off the Jam sleep mask. What are you going to need today out and about? You are going to need the WCIE sunglasses. Yeah, put those on if you can, Skates. Maybe a little bit small for Skates here today. All right, so Skates, it's a perfect day to do what? What should you do? You should maybe treat yourself with a Jam nail file. Look at that. All the stuff you can get here. And we got a swag booth set up here at the Jewel-Osco location. We got some Jam air fresheners here for you, too. Put one under each armpit. There you go, Skates. Don't want you smelling bad. What sort of items are you looking for people to fill that bag with?
We're looking for our top 8 items. Peanut butter, canned beans, canned vegetables, canned fruit, canned tuna is great. Any of those shelf-stable items would be fantastic.
And it's so easy because it's as people are buying maybe what they're buying groceries for the week, think about people that need some help.
Absolutely. A lot of kids this summer won't have their breakfast or their lunch because they're not in school. So we really need to fill this bus, get the food out to the community in need, and get the kids fed.
All right, fill the bag. Rick, you're helping us fill the bus. God, what a great day.
And the generosity of the Jam viewers, I'll tell you, a gentleman came by and he filled up 2 full rows of seats with his bags alone this morning. So let's keep it coming.
It's got to be inspiring.
Oh, indeed. Really is.
All right. So we're on the Chicago trolley and double-decker bus, and we can't end this without saying hello to our driver. Oh, we filled this bag. I was going to sit here. Hold on 1 second. I'll put this on my lap. All right. We got Alicia. How you doing this morning, Alicia?
I'm doing quite well. Thank you.
You drive a lot of people around. You do a lot of tours. It must be great to partner with this awesome cause.
Oh, yes, it is. And I am very honored to be a part of this on today.
Yeah, you having fun?
I am having a blast.
All right, so the one thing, I know you can't let me drive this thing, right?
No.
Okay, all right, because I'm always asking. But you got a horn on this thing, right?
Yes, I do.
Mind if I beep it a little bit?
Go right ahead.
We're in the parking lot. All right, so beep, beep, here we go. Fill a bag, fill a bus, fill a bag, fill a bus. Hopefully the police don't come after me now. All right, it's fill a bag, fill a bus. Where are we going to be today? Well, we're at the Jewel-Osco right now. We're at Kinsey and Desplaines, and we're going to be here till noon. Great stuff going on. Come by, fill a bag, fill a bus. And then we're packing things up, and we're heading to the South Loop. We're going to go to Roosevelt and Canal from 1 o'clock till 5 o'clock, and we're going to be there all afternoon, same sort of stuff. And then guess what? Tomorrow morning, we're going to be in River Forest from 6 a.m. until 3 p.m. with special guest Fenghouli. He's coming by around noon. He's going to be signing some autographs, having some fun, taking some photos. I mean, it's Fenghouli. Come on. And then all in all, no matter what, if you can't come out to a Jewel location, please, please go to WCIU.com. Every dollar helps provides 3 meals, and the Greater Chicago Food Depository does excellent work. It's an honor to be here as part of the Jam. We're going to fill this bus, and we're going to really be giving back to our wonderful community.